الله نزل أحسن الحديث كتابا متشابها مثانية تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Welcome to Quran Circle 8, where we listen to verses of the Quran and we reflect upon them and we revive something that we need to keep it revived in our homes, in our gatherings, and that is to recite the Quran and to get to understand what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us and to learn how to recite it and to perfect it. This is all part of exalting the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the Quran. And every reciter with us recites a page, so we make it easy for the followers. If you go and get a Quran and open it and follow inshallah ta'ala with the intention of learning and being blessed in a gathering of the Quran, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from all of us. Before we continue where we stopped last time, we are in Surah An-Nisa and page number 98. But before we start, I would like to introduce the reciters with us today. We have Sheikh Abdul Khaliq Atiyah. Jazakumullah khairan for coming. And Sheikh Karim Saudi, and Sheikh Asad Al-Hawi, and Sheikh Abdul Rahman Saeed. Barakallahu feekum. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for coming, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all sincerity and to make us all among the people of the Quran. We'll start inshallah ta'ala with Sheikh Abdul Khaliq Atiyah and Surah An-Nisa, verse number 122 to 127, page number 98. Go ahead, Sheikh Abdul Khaliq.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. والذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات سندخلهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار سندخلهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها أبدا وعد الله حقا ومن أصدق من الله قيلا ليس بأمانيكم ولا أماني أهل الكتاب من يعمل سوءا يجز به ولا يجد له من دون الله وليا ولا نصيرا ومن يعمل من الصالحات من ذكر أو أنثى وهو مؤمن فأولئك يدخلون الجنة ولا يظلمون نقيرا ومن أحسن دينا ممن أسلم وجهه لله وهو محسن واتبع ملة إبراهيم حنيفا واتخذ الله إبراهيم خليلا ولله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وكان الله بكل شيء محيطا ويستفتونك في النساء قل الله يفتيكم فيهن وما يتلى عليكم في الكتاب في يتامى النساء اللاتي لا تؤتونهن ما كتب لهن وترغبون وترغبون أن تنكحوهن والمستضعفين من الولدان وأن تقوموا لليتامى بالقسط وما تفعلوا من خير فإن الله كان به عليما.
بارك الله فيك، جزاكم الله خيرا. After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the previous verses about the disbelievers, about those who follow the shaitan, that they will be among the people of the hellfire, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that those who believed and do righteous good deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will admit them into gardens underneath which the rivers flows. They will be in it forever. And this is the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the promise of the truth. And no one is more truthful in speech than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This life, and to be obedient to Allah and to fulfill the purpose of our life, it's not according to the wishful thinking of yourselves, even if it's to the believers or to the people of the book. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the matter very clear. Whoever do evil, they will be recompensed by their own actions. And they won't find any help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if they change, if they deviate. And those who do righteous good deeds, whether it's male or female, and they are believers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make them among the people of Jannah. And there's no one best in one's religion than someone that submitted himself physically and his heart to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while he is a good doer, sincerely doing things for the sake of Allah, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if he sees Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if he doesn't see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is seeing him. Following the way of Ibrahim alayhi salam, he was upright upon the tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the oneness of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Ibrahim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took him as a close ally. Ibrahim alayhi salam was beloved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala belongs what's in the heavens and the earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encompasses everything with his power and his knowledge subhanahu wa ta'ala. When they asked the Prophet والسلام, about many different things in their life, one of which with regards to the orphans, the women among the orphans, those who they raise and they take care of, and then they grow up and they are in the age of marriage, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet والسلام, that their rights has to be fulfilled, because they used to, in times of ignorance, they would not fulfill the rights of the women in this case. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanding the believers to fulfill the rights of the women and to take care of the orphans and to treat them with goodness and justice. And anything of goodness that you do, have the certainty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all-knower over it. Then after that, the next page, page number 99 and verse 128 to 134, and Sheikh Karim, go ahead and recite for us, inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. وإن امرأة خافت من بعلها نشوزا أو إعراضا فلا جناح عليهما أن يصلحا بينهما صلحا والصلح خير وأحضرت الأنفس الشح وَإِن تُحْسِنُوا وَتَتَّقُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرًا وَلَن تَسْتَطِيعُوا أَن تَعْدِلُوا بَيْنَ النِّسَاءِ وَلَوْ حَرَصْتُمْ فلا تميلوا كل الميل فتذروها كالمعلقة وإن تصلحوا وتتقوا فإن الله كان غفورا رحيما وإن يتفرقا يغني الله كلا من سعته وَكَانَ اللَّهُ وَاسِعًا حَكِيمًا وَلِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَقَدْ وَصَّيْنَا الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَإِيَّاكُمْ أَنِ اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وإن تكفروا فإن لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وكان الله غنيا حميدا ولله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وكفى بالله وكيلا إن يشأ يذهبكم أيها الناس ويأت بآخرين وكان الله على ذلك قديرا من كان يريد ثواب الدنيا فعند الله ثواب الدنيا والآخرة وكان الله سميعا بصيرا.
بارك الله فيك جزاكم الله خيرا. These verses, one of which talks about when there's a dispute between a husband and wife, and the wife, she wants to continue with the relationship and this beautiful relationship between husband and the wife. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants the believers to keep it and to preserve it and not to take the path of terminating such a relationship because it involves dependencies like children and so on. So if the life is becoming very difficult between the husband and the wife, the matter of compromising some of the rights or some of the things so that life will go on, this is something that can be good in certain contexts to some individuals. And it's always the subject of a sulh or rectifying a situation or bringing peace is different than justice. Justice is to basically see who's wrong and who's right and to make a verdict when it comes to this. But when it comes to bringing peace, sometimes both sides, they have to compromise something to reach a common ground for the goodness that comes as a result of this. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands the believers. Because people, they, as human beings, we have this in ourselves to have this stinginess within our own selves and the greed. So we need to overcome this weakness by being generous and by being kind and having the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and knowing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is well acquainted of what we do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the believers, if a person is married to more than one wife, to be just and not to lean towards one and not the other, to the extent of which that he would leave one as if she's hanging, she's not married and she's not divorced. So to the command for the husbands to be just to their wives, and if they do what is right and upright and they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiver if it's something that is over their capacity with regards to the lenient to one or the other verse, basically from one's heart. And if they separate from one another by divorce or so, and after all of these means are taken, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will enrich them from His bounty subhanahu wa ta'ala. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala belong what's in the heavens and what's in the earth. The will of the people that was sent to the people of the book before to all nations is to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to have the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be obedient to Allah and to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if people disbelieve, it's still the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala belong to Him what's in the heavens and what's in the earth. They won't do any harm to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is repeated from one verse to the other. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala belong what's in the heavens and what's in the earth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most rich, He's the perfect one to be praised subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if He will, He would change you and replace you by other people. What brings the strength in the life of the believers is the fact that they believe in Allah and they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nobody will benefit Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or cause harm to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whoever wants the rewards of this world, only this world, belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the reward of this life and in the hereafter, which is such a powerful verse that this page ended with. And that is, even for you, if you want the materialistic benefits of this life, who's the owner of this life in the hereafter? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So seek that from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and if you seek the rewards in the hereafter, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the best of this life and in the hereafter. We continue inshallah ta'ala with the next page and verse 135 to verse number 140. And Sheikh Asad, go ahead and recite for us inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا كونوا قوامين بالقسط شهداء لله ولو على أنفسكم أو الوالدين والأقربين إن يكن غنيا أو فقيرا فالله أولى بهما فلا تتبعوا الهوى أن تعدلوا وإن تلووا أو تعرضوا فإن الله كان بما تعملون خبيرا يا أيها الذين آمنوا آمنوا بالله ورسوله والكتاب الذي نزل على رسوله والكتاب الذي أنزل من قبل ومن يكفر بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر فقد ضل ضلالا بعيدا إن الذين آمنوا ثم كفروا ثم آمنوا ثم كفروا ثم ازدادوا كفرا لم يكن الله ليغفر لهم ولا ليهديهم سبيلا بشر المنافقين بأن لهم عذابا أليما الذين يتخذون الكافرين أولياء من دون المؤمنين أيبتغون عندهم العزة فإن العزة لله جميعا وقد نزل عليكم في الكتاب أن إذا سمعتم آيات الله يكفر بها ويستهزأ بها فلا تقعدوا معهم حتى يخوضوا في حديث غيره إنكم إذا مثلهم إن الله جامع المنافقين والكافرين في جهنم جميعا.
جزاكم الله خيرا بارك الله فيكم. الله سبحانه وتعالى is calling the believers to be just even if it's against their own selves or against their parents or against their relatives or the fact that a person might be rich or poor. You might come into the sight of those who are rich or some people, they might come into the sight of those who are poor. No, be just, even if it's against whoever. Be just and be fair. Do not follow your desires. And this is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns the believers. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most just and He's the most merciful subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we saw that there's difference between bringing peace between two people and calling them to compromise something as long as it's not sinful for them, for life to go on, versus to have a verdict based on justice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called also the believers to believe in Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam and to believe in all of the books that were revealed before. And it's a call also for the people of the book and whoever disbelieve in Allah and the angels and the books and the messengers and the last day, they had deviated a far away deviation, which is basically disbelief. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about those who they were believers and then they renegated and they became disbelievers. Then they became believers and then disbelievers and then they increase in their disbelief and they die in the state of disbelief. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would never forgive them because they died in the state of disbelief. And this is basically some of the hypocrites, and that's why the verses is giving glad tidings in a mockery way for the hypocrites that there is a painful punishment waiting for them. And some of the characteristics of the hypocrites, those who would take the disbelievers as allies besides the believers. They would oppose the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala this way. They would cause harm to the believers as a result of this. And they seek izzah or honor and dignity with the disbelievers when the izzah and the honor and the dignity all belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam as a rule and as a command for the believers that if you are in a gathering and the signs of Allah, the verses of Allah, the deen of Allah is being mocked at and disbelieved at, then it's not permissible for you to sit with them in the same gathering till they indulge in another topic. Otherwise, and this is a very scary and a very dangerous thing, innakum idham mithluhum, which means you are indeed like them. You have the same ruling as them if you sit and you approve the mockery of the religion and so on. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will gather the hypocrites and the disbelievers in the hellfire, all of them together. And this is warning for the believers. Never listen, never watch the evildoers, those who make mockery of the religion and those who belittle the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After that, the next page, page 101 and verses 141 to 147. And Shaykh Abdul Rahman, go ahead and recite for us, inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. الذين يتربصون بكم فإن كان لكم فتح من الله قالوا ألم نكن معكم وإن كان للكافرين نصيب قالوا ألم نستحوذ عليكم وإن كان للكافرين نصيب قالوا ألم نستحوذ عليكم ونمنعكم من المؤمنين فالله يحكم بينكم يوم القيامة ولن يجعل الله للكافرين على المؤمنين سبيلا إن المنافقين يخادعون الله وهو خادعهم وإذا قاموا إلى الصلاة قاموا كسالى يراءون الناس ولا يذكرون الله إلا قليلا مذبذبين بين ذلك لا إلى هؤلاء ولا إلى هؤلاء ومن يضلل الله فلن تجد له سبيلا يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تتخذوا الكافرين أولياء من دون المؤمنين أتريدون أن تجعلوا لله عليكم سلطانا مبينا إن المنافقين في الدرك الأسفل من النار ولن تجد لهم نصيرا إلا الذين تابوا وأصلحوا واعتصموا بالله وأخلصوا دينهم لله فأولئك مع المؤمنين وسوف يؤتي الله المؤمنين أجرا عظيما ما يفعل الله بعذابكم إن شكرتم وآمنتم وكان الله شاكرا عليما.
بارك الله فيك جزاكم الله خيرا. More of the characteristics of the hypocrites, those who they wait and they watch for the harm to happen to the believers for them to take advantage of the believers. They really don't care about the believers, they would align themselves with the disbelievers to harm the believers. And they are with the believers physically, so if the believers are victorious, they would say, we are with you. And if the disbelievers are victorious, they would go to the disbelievers and they would ask for a share of what they've received and so on. This is how the hypocrites are. They have more than one face. They face people, they deal with people, they treat others with whatever benefit that they would get from this life. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, that even if they are left to do this in this life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will judge between the people in the Day of Judgment, and never the disbelievers will have a superiority over the believers forever. And that's why there's the Day of Judgment when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the disbelievers in the hellfire. The hypocrites, they think that they can deceive Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by this attitude. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deceive them in the day of judgment in a perfect way, as it's mentioned in Surah Al-Hadid, for example. One of their characteristics is whenever they would go for the salah, for the prayer, they are lazy. They're showing off to the people that they are believers and that they make salah, but in reality, they're just doing it for the people, not for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They only remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala very little. They do some remembrance, but it's very little, which shows that the believers should do the opposite of that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised the believers because they frequently make remembrance of Allah. The hypocrites are between basically the believers and the disbelievers. They see who wins and they go to their side. And these are the deviant ones. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after warning against the ways of the hypocrites, calling the believers not to be like them, but rather to be firm upon matters of faith. Do not take the disbelievers as allies besides the believers. Do you want to have an authority? Basically, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will then punish you as a result of that. You should seek the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then showing that the hypocrites indeed are in the worst and the lowest level of the hellfire, worse than the disbelievers, and they would never find a helper besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, except those who repent and they rectify their affairs and they hold fast to the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they sincerely worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That means they become again part of the belief and become with the believers. They are with the believers, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give the believers a great reward. So this is a call for them to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful. That's why the page ended with this verse that مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ إِن شَكَرْتُمْ وَأَمَنْتُمْ. If you are grateful to Allah, if you believe, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not punish you. The punish and in the hereafter is not for the benefit or for something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will benefit from. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most rich. He's in no need of his creation whatsoever. So for those who are grateful to Allah, by being obedient to Allah and they are believers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would reward them. And he's the all-knower subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most grateful subhanahu wa ta'ala. After that, we'll go through to more pages inshaAllah ta'ala towards the end of Surah An-Nisa, but we'll do that inshaAllah after the break. So stay with us inshaAllah.
وذلك هو الفوز العظيم وذلك هو الفوز العظيم
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Welcome back, and with more verses of the Quran from Surah An-Nisa, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for all of us and to accept our deeds. We reached page number 102 and verse 148 to 154, and Sheikh Abdul Khalid, go ahead and recite for us, inshaAllah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم لا يحب الله الجهر بالسوء من القول إلا من ظلم وكان الله سميعا عليما إن تبدوا خيرا أو تخفوه أو تعفوا عن سوء فإن الله كان عفوا قديرا إن الذين يكفرون بالله ورسله ويريدون أن يفرقوا بين الله ورسله ويقولون نؤمن ببعض ونكفر ببعض ويريدون أن يتخذوا بين ذلك سبيلا أولئك هم الكافرون حقا وأعتدنا للكافرين عذابا مهينا والذين آمنوا بالله ورسله ولم يفرقوا بين أحد منهم أولئك سوف يؤتيهم أجورهم وكان الله غفورا رحيما يسألك أهل الكتاب أن تنزل عليهم كتابا من السماء فقد سألوا موسى أكبر من ذلك فقالوا أرنا الله جهرة فأخذتهم الصاعقة بظلمهم ثم اتخذوا العجل من بعد ما جاءتهم البينات فعفونا عن ذلك وآتينا موسى سلطانا مبينا ورفعنا فوقهم الطور بميثاقهم وقلنا لهم ادخلوا الباب سجدا وقلنا لهم لا تعدوا في السبت وأخذنا منهم ميثاقا غليظا.
بارك الله فيك، جزاكم الله خير. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is instructing the believers to have the best way to conduct everything in their life, and one of which is when is it permissible for a person to express the wrongdoing that happened to him if he is oppressed or wrongdoing happened to him. Other than that, it's not a good thing for a person to speak about what's evil and so on. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says whether you show something or you conceal it or you pardon, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that pardons, and He's the one that is able to do all things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says those who disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the messengers of Allah, and they want to separate in belief between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His messengers. They say we will believe in Allah but not the messengers. Or they believe in some of the messengers of Allah and not other messengers of Allah. And they want to have something in between with their belief. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, these are the true disbelievers. Whoever disbelieve in one messenger of Allah, as if he disbelieved in all of the messengers of Allah, as if he disbelieved in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that means they are disbelievers. They're not believers. The believers, those who believe in Allah and the messengers, and they did not differentiate between one messenger or the other when it comes to belief. These are the ones that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them full rewards. And therefore part of the belief pillars of al-Iman to believe in the messengers of Allah. Whoever disbelieve in the messengership of Isa alayhi salam, he's a disbeliever. Whoever disbelieve in the messengership of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he's a disbeliever. And he will be in the hellfire forever if the message of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam reached him. After that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about what some of the people of the book, when they asked the Prophet والسلام, as a way of being stubborn, it's not a way of seeking the truth, that they want a book physically to come down from the heavens. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says they asked before their Prophet Musa السلام, which is even much greater than that. When they asked Musa السلام, for them to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees them when they asked for this, and this was something mentioned in Surah Al-Baqarah. And they even took a calf to be worshipped besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pardoned them, but they still continued in their disbelieving attitude and deviation. And He elevated the mount of a tur above them for them to submit themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they still disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, commanded them to enter the city of Jerusalem by the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but they disobeyed the orders of Allah, and they made mockery of the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, took from them the covenant not to transgress in the Sabbath, but they still transgressed the limits. So basically, what do you expect from them when you're calling them to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone and to be obedient to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After that, more of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about some of the people of the book, those who disbelieve in some of the messengers of Allah, and what of the evil actions that they did. and page number 103 and verses 155 to 162. And Sheikh Karim, go ahead and recite for us.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم فبما نقضهم ميثاقهم وكفرهم بآيات الله وقتلهم الأنبياء بغير حق وقولهم قلوبنا غلف فبما نقضهم ميثاقهم وكفرهم بآيات الله وقتلهم الأنبياء بغير حق وقولهم قلوبنا غلف بل طبع الله عليها بكفرهم فلا يؤمنون إلا قليلا وبكفرهم وقولهم على مريم بهتانا عظيما وقولهم إنا قتلنا المسيح عيسى بن مريم رسول الله وما قتلوه وما صلبوه ولكن شبه لهم وإن الذين اختلفوا فيه لفي شك منه ما لهم به من علم إلا اتباع الظن وما قتلوه يقينا بل رفعه الله إليه وكان الله عزيزا حكيما وإن من أهل الكتاب إلا ليؤمنن به قبل موته ويوم القيامة يكون عليهم شهيدا فبظلم من الذين هادوا حرمنا عليهم طيبات أحلت لهم وبصدهم عن سبيل الله كثيرا وأخذهم الربا وقد نهوا عنه وأكلهم أموال الناس بالباطل وأعتدنا للكافرين منهم عذابا أليما لكن الراسخون في العلم منهم والمؤمنون يؤمنون بما أنزل إليك وما أنزل من قبلك والمقيمين الصلاة والمؤتون الزكاة والمؤمنون بالله واليوم الآخر أولئك سنؤتيهم أجرا عظيما.
The Quran, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, makes things very clear. The things that human beings are having dispute upon, with things that they disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they have confusion about, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it very clear. Referring to the people of Bani Israel, those who broke the covenant between them and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and their disbelief. And they killed many of the prophets of Allah. And they would even claim that their hearts is enclosed, that the iman does not get into their hearts. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sealed their hearts because of their disbelief. And their disbelief when they accused Maryam, the mother of Isa alayhi salam, with such a huge and a great slander, accusing her, wal'ayadhu billah, of committing adultery. And so this is how evil, or the extent of evil that they did, accusing the most virtue of all women to accuse her with such an evil crime. And also their evil statement and belief when they said that they killed Al-Masih, Isa ibn Maryam, and he is a messenger of Allah. And they claimed that they killed him, and they did not kill him, nor they crucified him, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, but he was made similar to his image, someone else. But Isa alayhi salam, the son of Mary, he was never killed, he was never crucified. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ascended him to the heavens. And those who have differences in matters of belief with regards to Isa alayhi salam, they have doubts. There's no certainty to them whatsoever. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ascended him, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Almighty, the Most Wise. And there's no one from the people of the book, unless he would believe in the true Isa alayhi salam before they die. Before Isa alayhi salam dies, because Isa alayhi salam will descend back onto the earth, and people will see him clearly, and they would believe that he's a messenger of Allah and not son of God or the like of these matters of disbelief. Or before the death of every person from the people of the book, they would see the truth about Isa alayhi salam. And he will witness against them in the Day of Judgment. So Isa alayhi salam, the son of Mary, is a messenger of Allah, and he is someone that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to the people of Bani Israel to call them to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. So because of this transgression, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade on the people of Bani Israel many of the permissible things and the pure things because of their aggression and their disbelief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they would take and use and deal with usury, riba, interest and the like of this when they have been forbidden from it. And they would take the wealth of the people without the right of doing so. And you see, these things are not just warning the people of Bani Israel, but also warning this ummah not to follow the same path by disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But for among the people of the book, the Jews and the Christians, those who have knowledge and they believe in what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed before, and they believed in the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and they followed the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, like Abdullah ibn Salam radiallahu anhu and others. He was a chief among the Jews, and he believed in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam and followed him. And those who establish the salah and they give the zakah, those who believe in Allah and the last day, they are the ones that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them clear and great rewards from him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is straightforward, the direct matters of belief that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it very clear in the final revelation from Allah. Whoever is guided to follow this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow his favor upon. Whoever turns away from this truth, then they are being warned for a severe punishment in the Day of Judgment. We continue inshallah ta'ala with the next page, and page 104, verse 163 to 170. And Sheikh Asad, go ahead and recite for us, inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. إنا أوحينا إليك كما أوحينا إلى نوح والنبيين من بعده. وأوحينا إلى إبراهيم وإسماعيل وإسحاق ويعقوب والأسباط وعيسى وأيوب ويونس وهارون وسليمان وآتينا داود زبورا ورسلا قد قصصناهم عليك من قبل ورسلا لم نقصصهم عليك وكلم الله موسى تكليما رسلا مبشرين ومنذرين لئلا يكون للناس على الله حجة بعد الرسل وكان الله عزيزا حكيما لكن الله يشهد بما أنزل إليك أنزله بعلمه لكن الله يشهد بما أنزل إليك أنزله بعلمه والملائكة يشهدون وكفى بالله شهيدا إن الذين كفروا وصدوا عن سبيل الله قد ضلوا ضلالا بعيدا إن الذين كفروا وظلموا لم يكن الله ليغفر لهم ولا ليهديهم طريقا إلا طريق جهنم خالدين فيها أبدا وكان ذلك على الله يسيرا يا أيها الناس قد جاءكم الرسول بالحق من ربكم فآمنوا خيرا لكم وإن تكفروا فإن لله ما في السماوات والأرض وكان الله عليما حكيما.
جزاكم الله خيرا بارك الله فيكم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, these are matters of belief for us to be firm upon, that Allah revealed to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and he revealed to the prophets before the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, Nuh and the prophets, those who came after him, Ibrahim and Ismail and Ishaq and Ya'qub and Asbad, the sons of Ya'qub and Isa and Ayyub and Yunus and Harun, wa Sulaiman and Dawood, prophets of Allah, that are sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Messengers that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, like in the Quran or in the Sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and messengers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not mention their names in the final revelation from Allah. So we believe in all of them, those who are mentioned and those who are not mentioned. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevated some of the messengers over others with virtue, like Musa alayhi salam, and the best of all of the prophets of Allah is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam. All these messengers of Allah, they were sent to give glad tidings and to warn so that people don't have an excuse whatsoever. That means the message had reached them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Almighty, the Most Wise. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam the final revelation and the angels they witness, and the best of all witnesses is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and sufficient is the witness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The verses talks about those who disbelieve and oppose the people from seeing and from acknowledging the truth, that they had deviated, a far away deviation. Those who disbelieve and they transgressed and they wronged themselves, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not forgive them if they die in that state, and He would not guide them if they continue to be in such an arrogant and transgressing state. And they are taken basically the path of Jahannam, the path of the hellfire, and they will be in it forever. And this is something very easy and simple for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the messengers of Allah, they did not just come to give good news, they also warned against disbelief and disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is going to be in the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called the people, that the messenger of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he was sent bilhaq, by the truth, from your Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So believe, it's better for you. And if you disbelieve, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala belongs what's in the heavens and what's in the earth, and He's the all-knower, the most wise subhanahu wa ta'ala. Book, which is the book of Allah, precise, very clear, inviting the people to the truth. Don't be deceived by those who try to deceive you. Read the book of Allah and you will be guided by the will of Allah. The next page, from verse 171 to 175, and Sheikh Abdul Rahman, go ahead and recite for us, inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أهل الكتاب لا تغلوا في دينكم ولا تقولوا على الله إلا الحق إنما المسيح عيسى بن مريم رسول الله وكلمته ألقاها إلى مريم وروح منه فآمنوا بالله ورسله ولا تقولوا ثلاثة انتهوا خيرا لكم إنما الله إله واحد
إنما الله إله واحد سبحانه أن يكون له ولد له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وكفى بالله وكيلا لن يستنكف المسيح أن يكون عبدا لله ولا الملائكة المقربون ومن يستنكف عن عبادته ويستكبر فسيحشرهم إليه جميعا فأما الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات فيوفيهم أجورهم ويزيدهم من فضله وأما الذين استنكفوا واستكبروا فيعذبهم عذابا أليما ولا يجدون لهم من دون الله وليا ولا نصيرا يا أيها الناس قد جاءكم برهان من ربكم وأنزلنا إليكم نورا مبينا فأما الذين آمنوا بالله واعتصموا به فسيدخلهم في رحمة منه وفضل ويهديهم إليه صراطا مستقيما.
بارك الله فيك، جزاك الله خيرا. الله سبحانه وتعالى is calling the people of the book. Do not be extreme in your religion. This is the extremism in religion when people disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when they make up matters of belief that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not reveal. Do not say and talk about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except the truth. Indeed, Al-Masih, Jesus, the son of Mary, Isa ibn Maryam, is a messenger of Allah. And the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the word of for it to be, and he becomes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created him from nothing as he created the human beings. And he is someone that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose as a spirit from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for people to be guided. So believe in Allah and His messengers and do not say three, do not believe in the Trinity. This is falsehood. This is not what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Isa alayhi salam to call people to believe in. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one. He is the only one subhanahu wa ta'ala and therefore He is the only one worthy of worship. Glory be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He does not have a son. He's the most rich subhanahu wa ta'ala. Isa alayhi salam is a messenger of Allah. And to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala belong what's in the heavens and what's in the earth. So worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone and do not associate partners with Allah. Then after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also make it clear to the people of the book that Isa alayhi salam, Jesus the son of Mary, would not disdain himself from worshiping Allah. He's humbled messenger to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Isa alayhi salam himself, he worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's a slave of Allah and a messenger of Allah. And also the angels, they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala constantly. And whoever disdain himself and arrogantly turning away from the worship of Allah, these are the people that everybody will be gathered to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As for the believers, those who believe and do righteous good deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them their rewards in full and give them more from His bounty subhanahu wa ta'ala to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Jannah, to be admitted to Jannah. And for those who disdain themselves, arrogantly turned away from the worship of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish them, a painful punishment. They won't find any help besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After all of that is mentioned, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling mankind that the burhan and the evidence came to you from your Lord. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought down to you a clear light, nothing clearer than this, in matters of belief. Belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, worship Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So therefore, again, for those who believed and they hold fast to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make them admitted to the mercy of Allah and the bounties from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He would guide them to a straight path, to the straight path, which is the deen of Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us all, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us firm upon the deen of Allah, deenul Islam. There's only one verse left in Surah An-Nisa, but since we're going one page at a time, we'll do that inshallah ta'ala next time, and with the beginning of Surah Al-Ma'idah. So even though it's best to continue and to finish the entire surah in one context, but we'll do that inshallah ta'ala in the next episode. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us, and I would like to thank the reciters with us today. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you all and make us sincerity, give us sincerity in our intentions, in our deeds, and accept from us. So till next time, I leave you with the protection of Allah. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barak ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
الله نزل أحسن الحديث كتابا متشابها مثانية تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم مثانية تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم ثم تلين جلودهم وقلوبهم إلى ذكر الله.